Hello everyone and welcome to another video. I've had lots of people ask how much you can exactly charge for the different shops and stalls in the game, so that's what we're going to talk about today. This video is heavily based on Dirklink's guide to shop and stall prices, a link to which is in the description. The price that guests are willing to pay for a certain item depends on a lot of factors. The base price of that item, the temperature, whether it's raining, and the happiness of the guest. Let's go over those factors in that order. All items have a base price that all guests are willing to pay under normal conditions. For a balloon, this is 1.40 euro, for ice cream this is 1 euro, and so on. Those normal conditions mean that it's not too cold or too hot and it's not raining. If those things aren't true, then the price that guests are willing to pay may be different. If the temperature is 11 degrees Celsius or lower, it is considered to be cold, and this impacts the price of a lot of items. While the base price of ice cream is 1 euro when it is, say, 15 degrees, it drops to 60 cents when it is cold. On the other hand, the price of hot chocolate increases from 1 euro and 30 cents under normal temperatures to 2 euros when it's cold. If the temperature is 21 degrees Celsius or higher, it is considered to be hot, and this also impacts quite a few prices. The ice cream jumps from 1 euro to 1.50 when it's hot, and a tentacle decreases from 2.20 under normal temperatures to 2 euros when it's hot. Here is the full list of all items and their base prices under normal, hot, and cold temperatures. Some items, like the balloon, don't change at all, while others, like the aforementioned ice cream, change a lot depending on the temperature. The item with the highest base price and hot price is the t-shirt at 370, and the item with the highest cold price is the umbrella with 5 bucks. There is a link to a spreadsheet made by Dirklink with all this and more info in the description. There are 5 items that are impacted by rain. The first 4 are balloons, candy floss, ice cream, and sunglasses. If it is raining, guests will not buy these items, no matter the price. Umbrellas are the other way around. If it is raining, guests will always buy them, no matter the price, which is why you should always charge 20 euros for them. The last factor that determines how much you can charge is the happiness of the guests. Basically, the happier the guest, the more they are willing to pay. I explained the exact math behind this in my video about on-ride photos, so I won't do that again in this video, but I will go over the final numbers and the probabilities again. The happiness value of a guest ranges from 0 to 255. If it is below the halfway mark of 128, the guest has an 87.5% chance of still buying the item if you charge 10 cents more than the base value. If you charge 20 cents more, this chance goes down to 75%, and at 30 cents more than the base price, it's 62.5%. This continues all the way to a 0% chance if you charge 80 cents more than the base price. If the guest is instead fairly happy and has a happiness value between 128 and 179, then this range doubles. In this case, there is a chance that a guest will still buy the item all the way up to an overcharge of 1.50 euro. If the guest is very happy and has a happiness value of 180 or more, this range doubles again. Now, even at an overcharge of 3.10 euros, there is still a 12.5% chance that the guest buys the item. You could do an analysis on what the optimal amount to charge is, but I think that that gets very complicated very quickly. Some items, like sunglasses, can only be bought once, so you want to make sure that guests pay a very high price for them when they do buy them. turning a guest away isn't really a problem because they can try again later when they're happier or when the temperature is better. Other items like food and drinks are bought more often, so you might not want to turn away guests. Another thing to consider is the production cost. You may be able to charge up to $370 for a t-shirt, but every sale only makes you $170 as it costs $2 per t-shirt to buy them from the factory. Meanwhile, hot chocolate only has 40 cents in production costs, so you almost make the same per sold item when it is cold. All these factors, along with temperature changes and sometimes frequent rain, make it really complicated to optimize the price for every shop in every scenario. What I do know is that if you keep your guests very happy, you can get away with overcharging a bit without turning away many guests. Especially on popular items, that can be a valid strategy to make a little bit more money. It's probably not worth it to check the maximum price for every item, but memorizing a few for standard items like the balloon, burger and drink is helpful if you want to optimize your shop prices. I find it really interesting how many factors are considered when determining how much a guest wants to pay. It is entirely realistic that ice cream goes for less when it's cold and for more when it's hot, and the same goes for a lot of other items. It is also realistic that items like sunglasses don't sell at all when it's raining. And lastly, happy guests sometimes wanting to pay more is also not unrealistic. If I were in a theme park and was having a great experience, I would be willing to pay more for a t-shirt or some food than if I had a terrible experience. On the other hand, some people just have a set maximum for how much they want to pay for that stuff, no matter how happy they are. The random chance that decreases the more you overcharge simulates this nicely. And that was everything you need to know about how much you can charge for your shops and stalls. Big thanks to Dirklink for doing the research on this and several other topics. It is really great work that he has done for the community. If you found this interesting, consider giving this video a like or leave a comment. You can also subscribe or follow me on Twitch. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video.